அடுத்து எங்கள் கல்லூரி தலைவர் அவர்கள் எங்கள் கல்லூரிக்கு வருகிறது என்று சிறப்பித்த சீர்கன் பத்மபவன் அவர்களுக்கு நினைவு பற்றி வழங்குவார்.
This shows we stand together one. Here we call upon P. Padmini, first to become C, to share their views on Republicity.
Ask not what your country can do for you. Ask what you can do for your country. Good morning to one of our present here. I welcome our management, honorable chief guest of the day, respected principal, vice principals, teachers, and my dear friends. Today, we are celebrating the 71st Republic Day. We celebrated our first Republic Day on 26 January 1950, which was exactly 2.5 years after we became independent. For the whole period of 2.5 years, our learned men like Dr. Rajendra Prasad, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar and their whole team worked tirelessly to make it possible to accomplish the tremendous task of framing the world's lengthiest constitution for Republic India. There are several republics across the globe, but still, India is a special nation in spite of its diverse culture. Even 71 years of being Republic, we are still facing the situations like poverty, illiteracy, casteism, corruption, etc. We knew that we brace ourselves to fight against all of them. We can see future India free from all of those drawbacks. Aren't we lucky that we don't have to live under the fear of being bombed? We can sleep peacefully in our home. We don't have to spend the hungry days and gloomy nights. We are under the obligation for those who sacrifice their own life for fellow Indians and for those who are still guarding the borders so that we can sleep peacefully in our home. We youth represent the most dynamic segment of population, the future of our nation. India is considered as one of the youngest nation in the world. About 65% of the people are under 35 years of age. The youth should be an active drivers and not merely passive recipients for development. The youth can be empowered through technology. First of all, mobile phones are the best tool to access information which will enable us to upgrade our knowledge and skills and which will enable us to participate in the development activities. Secondly, learning opportunities from outside the classroom helps our young people to develop their group working and critical thinking skills. I quote a famous line from the poem of Rabindranath Tagore, "Where the mind is without fear and the head is held high, where the knowledge is free, where the world has not been broken up into fragments, where the mind is led forward by thee into ever-widening thoughts and actions, into freedom of heaven, my father, let my country away."
For insisting, India is facing transition. Now it's our time, as well as a duty, to be awakened.